In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of anterior part of hip. Especially, I am going to focus on this area. That looks triangle, right? That's why this area is called femoral triangle. Femoral triangle. Because it's triangle, there are three things that makes femoral triangle. One is here. This is inguinal ligament. Inguinal ligament. Next one is this one. This is sartorius. Sartorius. Last one is here. This is adductor longus. Actually, this muscle. Edge of adductor longus. Adductor longus. In femoral triangle, there are many, many tissues. That's why I'm going to explain what kind of tissues there are. So, let's focus on muscle first. There are three muscles, but let's look at two muscles here. These muscles are iliopsoas. Iliopsoas. Soas. You can divide iliopsoas two muscles. One is psoas. And one is, let's change color, iliacus. By the way, this is psoas. And this is iliacus. These two muscles are very important for hip flexion. Then iliacus is important for pelvic movement. And psoas has something to do with lumbar movement. These muscles are very important for hip movement, pelvic movement, lumbar movement, and posture. Very important muscles. One more muscle is this one. This is pectineus. Pectineus is very tiny muscle compared to other muscles. This is part of adductor muscles. Pectineus here. So in femoral triangle, there are three muscles. Psoas, iliacus, and pectineus. Let's move on to nervous tissues. In between psoas and iliacus, there is femoral nerve. Femoral nerve. This is biggest nerve in front of thigh. This nerve innervates quadriceps, important muscles, right? Femoral nerve. And there's one another nerve, which is this one. This is it. This is lateral femoral cutaneous. Lateral femoral cutaneous nerve. This is sensory nerve. It takes sensory information from lateral part of thigh. That's why this nerve is lateral femoral cutaneous. Two nerves in femoral triangle. Femoral nerve, this area. And lateral femoral cutaneous, here. Now let's move on to vascular system. Once again, this is femoral triangle. Now you see artery and vein. This is artery. This is femoral artery. Femoral artery. And let's change color. This is femoral vein. You know, femoral artery is very important for palpation. If you can palpate femoral artery, you can palpate femoral nerve and iliopsoas very, very easily. Let's say now you can palpate femoral artery. and go a little bit lateral, you can palpate femoral nerve. And go a little bit lateral, you can palpate iliopsoas. Iliopsoas. Do you remember? This is psoas. This is iliacus. So if you can palpate femoral artery, go lateral, you can palpate femoral nerve and iliopsoas. You know, being able to palpate this area is so important. This is just my experience. If somebody got tight tension of muscle here, they tend to have tight hip joint. So again, being able to palpate this area is very important. If I would like to add one more thing, there is lymphatic nodes here, especially around inguinal ligament. Oh my gosh, there are many tissues inside of femoral triangle: muscles, nerves, vascular systems, and lymphatic system. That's why knowing anatomy about here is very, very important. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.